Hi all, and welcome to Occult Melbourne Part 5. We're in the grounds of the St. Patrick's Cathedral. We have a water feature or a fountain here, so I just want to go through this fountain. This might take a little time, but just bear with me. On the fountain here we have an inscription from Revelations, so let's just go through this. The angel showed me a river whose waters give life. It flows as clear as crystal from the throne of God and of the Lamb. So you can see Aries here on this gold plate. What I'm suggesting is that this here has to do with the head and the mind and consciousness. So let's just proceed forth. I just want to have a close look at the at that verse that was on the fountain there. So from the King James Version, I'll just read through this and see if I can decipher it a little, okay? This word here means showed, okay? So, and he showed me a river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. So the Lamb is perhaps Aries, and Aries relates to the head. So what we are talking about here is a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding out of the head. Out of the head. On this fountain, the water is flowing out of the head, but we'll get into that a little later. So reading on, in the midst of the street of it and on either side of the river was there the tree of life. Now, what I'm suggesting here is that this has to do with the cosmos, and perhaps the river is the river of stars that goes across the sky, the Milky Way, and that so perhaps this part of the tree of life, this could be the Milky Way in this case, and then because we've got reference here to the tree of life, and it says just reading this, in the midst of the street of it and on either side of the river was there the tree of life, which bear 12 manner of fruits and yield her fruit every month. Well, if we have the Milky Way and we have 12 manner of fruits, we're perhaps talking about the constellations and the zodiac here. Okay, so just reading on, and the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. So in this case we're perhaps talking about angels and healing, but who knows, and the stars, okay? But I think you can see where I'm coming from here. And there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it. So we're talking about the head here becoming more at one with the cosmos. That's what I seem to be getting from this. So, just reading on further, and his servants shall serve him, and they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their foreheads. Well, what is in the forehead? So we have the pineal gland here, the forehead is here, and here is the pineal gland. And once again, Aries, the lamb, refers to the head. So, okay. And there shall be no more night there. And they need no candle, neither light of the sun, nor the Lord giveth them light, and they shall reign for ever and ever. So I think if you can read through that, I think you can see where I'm going with this. I just find it interesting on the on these followers of Hare Krishna that they highlight the pineal gland. The other interesting thing is these two lines here, which are perhaps representative of the brain, of the left and right hemispheres of the brain. Really interesting. Let's proceed on. So here is the fountain. So I'm suggesting that this part of the fountain has something to do with the head, okay? If we look at this head here, we can see this sort of cross design here and here and here. which is perhaps, they're like keystones. These are shaped like keystones, or the Templar cross as well. So we have these sort of parts coming into the enlightened pineal gland. I mentioned that Aries relates to the head. So we have Aries here and the head. So it relates to the head, just like the feet. The feet relate to Pisces, to the sign of Pisces, and so forth around here. But Aries relates to the head, and that's what we want to know for now. So I've just put these in here as well. These pictures. This is within the St. Patrick's Cathedral in Melbourne, and we can see the head sort of highlighted here as well. And we have these sort of keystones here coming out as well. And this would be the sun here, and we have these rays, photons, and electricity perhaps, and magnetism and energy from the sun. In the St. Andrew's Cathedral in Sydney, we have a similar drawing going on, illustration within the stained glass windows, where we have the rays coming down, and they're actually sort of sine waves coming down to the people and to their heads, and their heads are being highlighted, and they're kind of being awakened here. They have this single sort of keystone above them, which is quite interesting. Anyway, let's keep moving on. So we'll just stick to this fountain. So while we have this view here, we have these what are seven plates running down here, and then we have, and then it proceeds down here, and we have what I'm suggesting is one area here, two areas, and then three areas running down this way. So let's just move on a bit further. Okay, so now I'm just going to try and explain this fountain a bit further. What I'm suggesting is that this part here sort of represents the awakened brain, the awakened pineal gland. And then we have a progression going down to the, we start at the moon here, where perhaps the consciousness can bounce off the moon if it's not fully awakened and ready to sort of progress through the spheres. So I'm suggesting that these seven plates here relate to the seven spheres, the seven orbs in the sky, going in order here, in the hermetic order of the Moon, Mercury, Venus, Sun, Mars, Jupiter, and then the last plate here is Saturn, and I want you to remember that this last plate is Saturn, as the soul perhaps moves out of our solar system, let's say, through the rings of Saturn. So this perhaps represents Saturn. Now, on the Tree of Life here, on the Kabbalah, we have, this would be Earth, Malkuth, and we have this sort of cross design here as well, which is sort of similar to what we sort of see on here. Anyway, this would be the Moon, then Mercury, then Venus, the Sun, Mars, Jupiter, then across to Saturn, and then this would be Uranus and Neptune up here. But in the old days, there were seven visible orbs in the sky. So that's what we have here, the seven visible orbs. And then from Saturn through those rings, once you go through those rings, you would go into the Ain, and then the Ain Sof, and then the Ain Sof Ur. And what I'm suggesting is that the Ain and the Ain Sof Ur, Ain Sof and the Ain Sof Ur are these three regions here. Okay, so now, remembering that last one was Saturn, let's just move on to the next part here. So we're just going to have a little aerial view onto what we just looked at there. So this part here, once again, is perhaps the Ain Sof, and then the Ain Sof-Ur, like that. And that's the first part of the fountain there with the pineal gland. So now we have a view of This is the in Melbourne, the St. Patrick's Cathedral area that we just looked at, and here is a view looking down into the Botanic Gardens of Adelaide. Now, in a similar fashion here, we have another sort of water feature here. The water flows from here to here, just as the water flows from here to here. Now, remember that this last plate here was Saturn. Well, here we have a black cube, and I will show you this just after I go through this. So we have a black cube here, and then the water flows from here. We have that square, square in there. So this is perhaps the Ain, then the Ain Sof, and then the Ain Sof Ur. So, okay, let's just keep going. So we'll just have a closer look. Here is the black cube. And a viewer sent me this footage from Adelaide, so I'm thankful for that. And this is the end of that water feature there, as the water sort of flows into the last part of the water feature. So I think that's interesting that we have such a similarity there. Whether or not it's a massive coincidence, I'm not sure. We have a poem on here, mention of fire, and we have water coming across, but I'm not going to go into a breakdown of that. So there's just another view of the fountain that we've looked at. And, you know, perhaps I'm right on that, and perhaps I'm completely wrong as well. Anyway, beautiful old church, a classic design, the St. Patrick's Cathedral. So here we have the St. Peter's Church. So we were just here looking at this part of the St. Patrick's Cathedral, and now we have the St. Peter's Church here. So we'll just have a little look at the logo of that. So that's the logo there, and in the logo you can see an inverted cross. And there it is there, an inverted cross again. And this is the logo of the St. Peter's Church. That's the St. Peter's Church right there. In Sydney, there's the Albion Pub or Albion Bar, and it's got the inverted cross as well. And here you can see by the way, Sydney was almost called Albion. And here you can see the Pope in his chair or throne there with an inverted cross there as well. So, according to Catholics or perhaps Christians, Saint Peter was sacrificed or executed on a cross, and the cross was placed upside down so that because Jesus was supposedly put on a cross the other way up, he wanted it to be upside down because it wouldn't be right for him to be crucified in the same way that Jesus supposedly was. So we'll just move on from that. Aries. I'll just talk about Aries here for a moment on this crucifixion thing. So here we actually have a lamb. We have the sun here coming down. This would be the time of Aries, the time when the sun comes up over the horizon into the over the equatorial plain into the northern hemisphere, and everyone is hopeful for bountiful growth and a good harvest and all the rest of it. So the sun is said to consume Aries, and there are also perhaps sacrifices that take place at this time of year from about March the 20th to about May the 1st for the northern hemisphere. So here we can see that the lamb or ram has been pierced in the chest here, and there is blood coming out into this chalice. In a similar fashion here we have this man here, Jesus, where he's being sort of pierced in the chest as well, in the same sort of fashion. Anyway, so here is another depiction of a lamb with the on a stained glass window with the blood pouring from the breast there into a sort of a chalice type thing. So just to add extra context to the black cube perhaps relates to Saturn. Father Time or Kronos perhaps relates to Saturn and also to death. This fountain is dedicated to two pioneering families, the Balnaves and Cronks. James Cronk and Robert Balnaves have since passed on, but the cycle of life continues as their descendants still populate the state of South Australia. So I hope you found that interesting, and I'll see you in part 6. Bye for now.